So greetings from Department of Commerce, Nehru Arts and Science College, Coimbatore. So I am here for you to provide some basic information about corporate accounting. So I am Dr. V. Venkatachalam, Assistant Professor, Department of Commerce, Nehru Arts and Science College. In today's session, I'm going to make you learn about introduction about corporate accounting and share capital and different types of share capital and subscription, minimum subscription, under subscription and over subscription, issue of shares, calls in arrear and calls in advance, and related such information for your knowledge sharing. So let us start the session with introduction about corporate accounting and also the share capital. So introduction in the sense, you all know about the basic accounting and accounting rules and regulations. So accounting is a systematic maintenance of books of record by following generally accepted accounting principle, GAAP. It means that we have to follow certain rules and regulations while preparing accounting statements. So what is the purpose we are maintaining different books of records and prepare various reports is that to identify the profit and loss of the business in a year, in a financial year, that is 1st April 2022, 31st March 2021, 12 months, April to March. So during this 12 months period, what is the company's performance in terms of finance, in terms of profit and loss, whether the company earned profit or not during this period. So how we can know these things with the help of maintaining books of records in a systematic manner? By the way of preparing profit and loss account, you can get profit or loss of the company. Then, what is the second objective of accounting? To identify the financial position of the company. Financial position of the company in the sense, by the way of preparing balance sheet, you can analyze what is the financial position as of now. For example, if you start a company during the year 2010, almost we have completed 11 years. So during this 11 years, what are the assets you have? What are the liabilities you have? What is the financial position? What is the long-term assets you have? Okay, so like this, we can get the information with the help of books of records and also the maintenance. So in financial accounting, actually there are three branches of accounting: financial accounting and management accounting and cost accounting. So this financial accounting is focused only on preparing profit and loss account and preparing balance sheet. It is statutory one, it is mandatory. If your company is registered under Companies Act, you have to submit your profit and loss account statement and balance sheet every year. Okay. The management and cost accounting is purely internal purpose. So the financial accounting is purely external, both internal and external. The stakeholders of financial report is customers, creditors, suppliers, public people, the company owner, company employees, like that we can say the stakeholders of financial accounting. The cost and management accounting is purely internal purpose. In order to identify the cost per unit, we are maintaining cost accounting. With the help of cost accounting procedures and formulas and formats, we can identify the cost per unit of the product. Why we need to identify the cost per unit? Then only we can fix the selling price. So based on the cost per unit, we add profit and we fix the selling price. Am I right? Okay. Then what is the purpose of management accounting? So management accounting is termed as accounting for decision making. So decision making is essential one. We need to prepare various reports, various analysis by the way of doing the things. Then we will get some valuable information to take some decisions that would help the business in a growth way. So apart from these things, we have an account called corporate accounting. Corporate accounting. Accounting for corporate. Or we can say that accounting for share capital. You know very well, balance sheet consists of assets and liabilities. You have a part called liabilities. In liabilities, you have a term called capital. So this corporate accounting is only focused on the share capital. So it only focuses on the share capital in the sense liability side of the balance sheet, especially long-term liabilities. I can tell you the some few items in the long-term liabilities. We can say that equity shares and preference shares and debentures and long-term loan. Clear. So this corporate accounting is only focused on accounting for share capital. Accounting for share capital. So that share capital, what do you mean by share capital? Yes, finance is the lifeblood of the business. Total amount required to run the business is called share capital. Total amount required to run the business is called share capital. It means that for smooth conduction of the business, a company required 1 crore rupees. That 1 crore rupees is called as share capital. The entire amount to run the business, required to run the business. So what do you mean by shares? What do you mean by shares? So let us discuss later. Before that, we'll discuss about some different types of share capital. So share capital is total amount required to run the business is called share capital. So that share capital is divided into few types. Authorized share capital, issued share capital, subscribed share capital, called up share capital, uncalled up share capital, paid up share capital, unpaid up share capital. So what do you mean by authorized share capital? Authorized share capital, it means that the maximum amount a company can collect from the public by the way of issuing prospectus. See, the companies are inviting public to invest in their company with the help of prospectus, they called public to invest in their company. So authorized capital, it means that the maximum amount which is approved by the SEBI and Company Law Tribunal, Register of Companies. As a businessman, you have to apply to collect funds from the public. You need to get approval from the SEBI and the Register of Companies. At that situation, the Register of Companies will give authorized capital limit, 1 crore or 1 lakh, depends upon the company, it will differ. So what is issued share capital? The next one is issued share capital. So out of authorized share capital, at the initial stage, let us take example, 10 lakh rupees is your authorized share capital. So out of 10 lakh rupees, 5 lakh rupees may be needed at the time of initial stage. So for that 5 lakhs alone, the company will issue share. That is called issued share capital. Out of that 5 lakh rupees, the public may be applied only for 4 lakh rupees shares. That is called subscribed capital. So authorized capital, the maximum limit, maximum amount can be collected, that is called authorized capital. issued share capital means based on the requirement, the company will call the public to invest as a partial amount from the authorized capital. And what is subscribed? Subscribed, it means after inviting the public may be applied only for 4 lakh rupees share capital amount. That is called subscribed capital. Then called up capital and uncalled up capital. So out of that 4 lakh rupees share value, the company may be called investors to pay 2 lakh rupees. That is called up capital. That 2 lakh rupees, the collection of 2 lakh rupees is called up capital. Uncalled up capital, remaining 2 lakh rupees. That's all. Then what is next one? Paid up capital and unpaid up capital. So paid up capital, it means that out of the 2 lakh rupees invited, called up, what is the amount paid by the investor? It may be 1 lakh rupees or 1 lakh 50 or 1 lakh 70,000. It depends upon the business situation and the investor level. So unpaid up capital in the sense it is, we can say that out of that 2 lakh rupees, 1 lakh 50,000 paid up means remaining 50,000 rupees unpaid up capital payment in default. We can say like that. Okay. So let us go, what is shares? You know what is share capital? Share capital is the total amount required to run the business. Now what is shares? Share, it means a small part. Capital will be divided into small part in equal value or uniform value. We can say that uniform value. Share capital is divided into small part of uniformed value. So there are two type of shares. There are two type of shares. One is equity shares. Another one is preference shares. So let us discuss about preference shares first. So why? Because the name, it has preference. Okay. Why I am selecting preference share first? That will be the example. Because preference shares will always have preference in right to claim dividend. So preference shares will always have preference. Preference first. At the time of dividend settlement, at the time of winding up of the company, the preference shareholders will be settled first. That's why I take preference share capital with the preference. Okay, right. So preference share capital will have a fixed dividend rate. Maybe 5% or 6%, it depends upon the company. The dividend rate will be fixed. What is equity shares? Equity shares is those shares which are not preference shares is called equity shares. Please understand. So those shares which are not preference shares is called equity share. That's all. It's very simple. Or we can say that ordinary shares. For example, 100 shares is there. Out of that, 80 shares is preference shares. It means what? Preference, it means preference in right to claim dividend, preference in right to settle at the time of winding up. So everywhere they have a preference. So that's why preference shares. So those shares which are not preference share is called equity shares. Okay, I hope you understood the concept. Share, it means a small part of share capital. There are two types, equity shares and preference shares. Preference shares, it means that preference in rights, and equity shares, it means that those shares which are not preference shares are called as equity shares. Next head, prospectus. You all know what is prospectus. It is an invitation. We can say that it is an invitation to the public. Invitation to the public. It means that you are inviting, as a company, you are inviting public people to invest in your company. Subscription. The another heading is subscription. What do you mean by subscription? After authorization of capital limit, the company will decide issue of capital, issue of shares. Out of that issue of shares, the subscription done by the public people. Subscription is done by the public people. It means it is purchased by the shareholders, public people. So there are three types of subscription: equal subscription, under subscription, and over subscription. So the company issued 10,000 shares. The public applied 10,000 shares. Allotment made 10,000 shares. It means equal subscription. All the issued shares were applied, all the applied shares were allotted. And under subscription, it means issued share is 10,000, applied 8,000, allotted 8,000. I hope you get my point. And what do you mean by oversubscription? Issued 10,000 shares, applied 8,000, 12,000 shares, allotted 10,000 shares. If you receive equal application, that is equal subscription. If you receive less than the issued application, under subscription. If you receive more than the issued application, that is oversubscription. Next one is issue of shares. There are three types. There are three ways. Issue at par, issue at premium, issue at discount. Issue at par, it means the shares will be issued based on the face value. The shares will be issued based on the face value. It means, for example, a share value is 10 rupees. The issue price is 10. It means shares issued at par. Issued at a premium. In addition to the face value, 1 rupee or 10%, it depends upon the company, the premium will be added based on the goodwill of the company, based on the potential efficiency or effective rate of return or previous year's experience, that will define issue of at premium. The third one is issue at discount. Issue at discount, it means the shares will be issued less than the face value. The shares will be issued less than the face value. It means issue a discount. For example, the share value is 10 rupees, but issued to the public for rupees 9. Okay. So there are three types: issue at par, issue at premium, issue a discount. The next one is calls in arrear and calls in advance. So what is calls in arrear? It's very simple. When called up capital, there is a payment in default. The public people or the investor may fail to pay the call money, is called up capital and call scenario. So called up capital, payment in advance, calls in advance, that's it. So the shareholders or the investor, if fail to pay their call money, is called as call scenario. If the shareholders or investor or public people is pay in advance, is called as payment in advance. So what is the accounting treatment for this issue of shares? So there are different journal entries are there at the time of application. At the time of application, we have four type of journal entries. One is when application money received, bank account debtor to share application account. When transferring application money, share application account debtor to share capital. When rejecting excess application, share application account debtor to bank account. When adjust excess application, share application account debtor to share allotment. So at the time of allotment, we have three type of journal entries. One is face value. When share is issued face value, share allotment account debtor to share capital. When share is issued at a premium value, share allotment account debtor, share premium account debtor to share capital. When it is discounted value, share allotment account debtor, share capital account debtor, share capital account and share discount account. Forfeiture and reissue. What do you mean by forfeiture and reissue? Forfeiture is nothing. The word called process of cancelling at the time of no payment. Please understand, when the shares is allotted, the investor is sole responsible to pay the share money by the way of first call or second call or allotment money. That will be different from company to company. If a person failed to pay the call money, the cancellation allotment shares will be cancelled. That is called forfeiture. The same forfeiture, the cancelled shares will be reissued to someone else. That is called a reissue. I hope you get my point. A person wants to pay 100 shares into 100 rupees. He failed to pay that 100 rupees. The company will cancel the shares. That process is called as forfeiture. Okay, so after the forfeiture is done, that 100 shares will be issued to someone else. That is called a reissue of cancelled shares. It may be to existing shareholder at a discount rate or to the public based on, depends upon the company situation. Depends upon the company situation. So issue of shares at a premium and discount. Let us go with one example question. With this aspect. So issue of shares at a premium, it means that shares are said to be issued at a premium when a shareholder is required to pay more than the face value of the company. Please understand. So the investor is need to pay more. Share allotment account it are two share capital, two securities premium. Once payment is received, bank account it are two share capital. Issue of shares at discount. What it means? Issue of shares at discount. So shares are said to be issued at a discount when the shareholder is required to pay less amount than the face value of the company. It will be goes to debited to discount on issue of shares. So it is the asset side of the balance sheet under the miscellaneous expenditure. Miscellaneous expenditure. So normally the rate of discount should not exceed 10% of the nominal value of the shares. You know what is nominal value, face value. So the journal entry is share allotment account debtor, discount on issue of shares account debtor, two share capital. So let us go with this question. Mr. A Limited issue 5000 shares of 10 each at a premium of rupees 5 per share. The amount was payable as rupees 3 on application, rupees 7 on allotment including premium, and the balance on first and final call. All shares were subscribed and money duly received. Show the journal entry. So please understand the question. A Limited issued 5000 shares of 10 each. Number of shares is 5000. The face value of the share is 10 rupees. At a premium, issue at a premium. Please understand. Premium of rupees 5 per share. So here the shares issued at the premium. The original price of the share is 10 rupees. It is issued at a premium of rupees 5 per share. So the share value will be 15. So the amount was payable as rupees 3 on application. Along with the application, you have to pay 3 rupees. At the time of allotment, you have to pay 5 rupees premium amount and 2 rupees allotment money. Remaining 5 rupees, you have to pay at the time of first and final call. So as per this question, all shares were subscribed and money was duly received. Let us see the journal entries. First one, bank account debtor to share application account. So please understand, each transaction we have two journal entries. Each transaction we have to post two journal entries. Here there are three type of transaction is there. One is application, another one is allotment, another one is first and final call. Please understand. So there are three business transactions is happened. One is application, another one is allotment, another one is first and final call. So we have to prepare six journal entries. The first one is bank account debtor to share application application money received. When receiving application money, bank account debtor to share application 5000 into 3 rupees. Why? Because application money is 3 rupees, so 15,000. The second journal entry, once you receive the application money, you have to transfer the application money to share capital. For that journal entry will be share application account debtor to share capital. So entire 15,000 going to be transferred share capital account. And the second journal entry, what is the second transaction? Share allotment. So share allotment account debtor to share capital to securities premium. Please understand why, because allotment made with premium. So at the time of allotment, you have to pay along with the premium amount. So what is the journal entry? Share allotment account debtor 35,000 to share capital because 10,000, because 5,000 shares into rupees 2 allotment money. So 5,000 into rupees 2, you will get 10,000. And to securities premium, what is the premium amount? 5 rupees. So this 5 rupees will be transferred to securities premium account. 5,000 into 5 rupees, 25,000. So once you receive the allotment money, bank account data, share bank account data 35,000 to share allotment 35,000. So share first and final call, the balance 5 rupees you are going to collect from the public at the time of first and final call. So 5,000 into 5, 25,000. Once you receive the share capital, share allotment money and application call money, then that will be transferred to share capital account. So bank account debtor to share first and final call account. So I repeat, there are three type of issues. One is issue at par, issue at premium, issue at discount. If issue of shares done at par, the same question will let us take issue of shares at par. What will be the journal entry? Bank account debtor to share application 5,000 into 3, 15,000. Share application account debtor to share capital, being money transferred to share capital. Share allotment account debtor 10,000 to share capital. Why? Because shares issue at par. Shares issue at par. Once you receive the allotment money, share allotment money, bank account debtor to share allotment 10,000. Why? Because allotment money 5,000 shares into 2, 10,000. Share first call and final call 5,000 into 5, 25,000. If you receive the bank account, call money, bank account debtor to share first and final call, the amount will be transferred. That will be in case of what? In case of par, issue at par. At the situation of issue at discount, bank account debtor to share application 15,000, share application account debtor to share capital 15,000, share allotment account debtor to share capital, before that share allotment account debtor discount on issue of shares, discount on shares account debtor to share capital. Please understand, if it is securities premium, it will be comes under credit side. If it is discount, it will goes to debit side. So the bank account to share allotment account and share capital, share first and final call account to share capital, bank account debtor to share first and final call. So let us have another one example with real time experience. Let me show you with the help of an Excel sheet. Please stay tuned. So let us go with the real-time example. So let us take Bharat Limited, issue of 5,000 shares. Bharat Limited issue of 5,000 shares. Or let us take B Limited, issue 5,000 shares. At face value of rupees 10. So this 10 rupees is going to collect at the time of application rupees 2, at the time of allotment rupees 3, at the time of first and final call rupees 5. So this 10 rupees is going to collect by the company 3 times. One is allotment application time 2 rupees, allotment time 3 rupees, and first and final call 5 rupees. Okay, so what will be the first journal entry? Being application money received, bank account debtor 5,000 into 2, 10,000. 2 share application, 10,000. Being application money received. Once you receive the money, you have to transfer. Am I right? So share application account debtor, same 10,000. 2 share capital. Please understand, you have to transfer like this. What is the second journal entry? Allotment entry. So what is the allotment? Share allotment account debtor. What is the allotment amount? 2 rupees. 5,000 into 3 rupees. So 15,000. So allotment account 15,000. 2 share capital, 15,000. Okay, so to be received entry is made, allotment money due, being allotment money due. Once you received allotment money, bank account debtor 15,000, 2 share allotment, 15,000. Okay, what is the next one? First and final call. You have to create to be collected entry. So share first and final call. Final call account debtor 5 rupees into 5,000. So 5 into 5, 25,000. 2 share capital. Again, same 25,000. And once you receive the money, 25,000, bank account debtor 25,000, 2 share first and final call. First and final call, 25,000. I hope you clear with this now. So we have example question. B Limited issue 5,000 shares at face value of rupees 10. This face value will be collected 3 times. Application time 2 rupees. Allotment time 3 rupees. First and final call 5 rupees. Bank account debtor, 2 share application 10,000 when you receive application money. Share application account debtor, 2 share capital. Application money transfer to share capital. 2 journal entries is over. Then next transaction. share allotment account are to share capital, bank account debt are to share allotment. Then last one, share first and final call account debt are to share capital, bank account debt are to share first and final call. So like this, we need to prepare issue of shares, journal entries. I hope you all enjoy with this session. Let us thank the Almighty for providing this opportunity. So thank you very much. Thank you all for your patient listening. Thank you all.